Several years ago, zoos around the country realized that their animals were producing something valuable, and the notion of zoo-doo was born. Instead of paying for waste to be removed, they either sell or donate thousands of pounds in exotic manure. I went to Buttonwood Park Zoo in New Bedford recently to visit my elephant pals, Emily and Ruthie, two of the biggest contributors to the zoo-doo, to see how it works. Have a look. The greeting ritual of trumpeting and rumbling and drumming signals the joy of the elephants and the elephant keepers when they are reunited each morning. It's amazing to hear. But we're visiting this early because we're after something else the elephants produce, besides music.
About 60% of what goes in comes out.
Did you hear that? The acoustics are so bad in the elephant barn, we may not have. But Dr. Bill Langbauer, the director of the Buttonwood Park Zoo, and a world-renowned elephant expert, has just told me that elephants only digest 40% of their food. The other 60% comes out as waste. In winter, when they eat more, that might mean nearly 100 pounds in a day. I'm interested in what's called zoo-doo, and clearly, I've come to the big producers. As it happens, I've been spending a lot of time lately with Emily and Ruthie, the two Asian elephants at Buttonwood. And so I stopped to say hello. Actually, I can't keep my hands off them. Ruthie is the love bug, and Emily is a musician who likes to drum. First, I get to watch the girls do their morning Tai Chi. Back legs up, front legs up, kneeling with their heads down. Ruthie stops for a little light refreshment, and then it's time for me to dig in. Someone I've come to admire, Jenny Blackburn, tells me which quadrant to clean, and after I get accustomed to the wheelbarrow, I get going. I seem to need my foot to scoop.
Is it cheating to use my foot?
It's something the experts wouldn't dream of doing. Plus, their side is looking pretty clean, and I'm still at it. Well, I'm delving deeper into the mystery. For instance, what's inside one of these? I put on some gloves, and voila, just as Dr. Bill said, clearly they've been eating hay. It's back to work, and even though I'm doing my best, when you're shoveling elephant poop, everyone's a critic. Listen to video artist Kristen Gogan, who is generally silent behind the camera.
Hey, you missed some.
I missed some.
Behind you.
Finally, I'm finished with the big stuff.
Nice job.
Now it's off to the dumpster, the crucial part. This is where Silverbrook Farm, a sustainable farm in Dartmouth, Mass., will come to pick up the rich fertilizer. A little sweeping, and the hay is cleaned up. I heave the last load in and wipe the sweat from my brow, the first honest day's work I've done in years. And after all that back-end attention, I deserve a little more FaceTime with the girls.